So Paul stood up in front of the council and said, "People of Athens, I see that you are very religious. As I was going through your city and looking at the things you worship, I found an altar with the words, 'To an unknown God.' You worship this God, but you don't really know him. So I want to tell you about him. This God made the world and everything in it. He is the Lord of heaven and earth, and he doesn't live in temples built by human hands. He doesn't need help from anyone. He gives life, breath, and everything else to all people. From one person, God made all nations who live on earth, and he decided when and where every nation would be. God has done all this so that we will look for him and reach out and find him. He isn't far from any of us, and he gives us the power to live, to move, and to be who we are. We are his children, just as some of your poets have said." Those words come from Acts 17, verses 22 to 28. Do you worship an unknown God? Is God someone you know or know about? There are many people who know about God, but there are few who know him. The people of Athens were at least very honest in that they recognized that there was a God that they did not know. They even worshiped this unknown God. Do you worship an unknown God? Do you know much about God, even though you have not been alone with him long enough to get to know him? When you read the Bible, do you hear his voice? When you come to a crossroads in life, do you sense the Holy Spirit nudging you in the direction you should go? When you pray, do you know that the Almighty Creator God is bending his ear in your direction? Do you see his footsteps in the sand all around you? Have you found the Bible verse that he wrote specifically with you and your needs in mind? Can you feel God's presence as much in the storm or in the desert as you do in the plentiful calm? Let knowing God and bringing him praise be the goal of your life, and more specifically, the goal of this day. Open your eyes and watch God work all around you and even through you. Notice how he responds to other people. Make sure your prayer time is a two-way conversation and you let God do most of the talking. Lord, in so many ways, you are an unknown God to me. I ask you, Lord, today to lead me to know you more. May you be the hand that moves me and the friend who comforts. May you be the one that I live for and reason to die. Hold me close enough that I can feel your heartbeat strong against my breast. Amen.